Data visualization is one of the most critical skills for any analyst and really most business people to know. No matter how good you are at analyzing data, if you can't package it in a way that communicates what you've learned and is easy for other people to understand, then a lot of that analysis gets lost. Hi, I'm Jen. Welcome to the channel. Let's look at the top 5 data visualization tools that you should learn. I've gone through a few different criteria in deciding which products to include because there are a lot of options out there and it's really hard to go wrong with any of them, but there are some that I think are more important for you to learn first before learning others. The first criteria is availability and usage. So how many customers do they have? Meaning, how many potential employers do you have that are going to want you to have this skill as your visualization tool? I think this is really key when deciding which tool to use or which skill set to build for a job. The second criteria is how easy is it to learn? And combined with that, how easy is it to use? There are some products that offer fantastic options if you know a lot of coding, and there are others that you need to know no coding whatsoever to be able to use. So I think that's an important criteria because it can also mean how long does it take you to be somewhat proficient with using that tool. Third, quality of data visualizations. Let's be honest, if it looks like crap or like you hand drew the visualization, it does not belong in your list of skill sets to learn. Unless you're in a company or want to get into a company that uses a legacy system, and even in those cases, I still recommend learning one of these newer tools. You want to learn a tool that has great visualizations, a quality that reflects the quality of the inputs that you're giving it. Fourth, I'll talk a little bit with each of these products on whether they're better suited for big data or smaller amounts of data, because I think this does make a difference which one you should learn depending on the industry and company that you're getting into. Many of them translate well one to another, but most programs are set up that they're either really geared towards lots of information and a heavy IT setup, or they're geared towards user-entered data, whether it's spreadsheets or the like, that make them much more flexible with small amounts of data, but can sometimes make connecting vast amounts of data very difficult or bog the system down. So we'll look at that a little bit. And my fifth criteria, cost and ease of setup. So this again talks a little bit about big data versus small data, which I think also gets into what size company or industry are you getting into. If you're getting into a company that's a startup or a smaller company, small to mid-size, they're probably going to be going with a cheaper solution because they just can't afford the investment of some of the more expensive tools that are out there, even if in some cases the more expensive tools are better tools. I think really at the end of the day, there are so many tools that are equivalent, and it's really just a matter of the application that you have, that some are more suited to certain companies, certain industries than others, and that's not a bad thing. I think that customization makes it really nice for companies to pick what they need and also for you to know what type of program that you should learn to boost your data visualization skills. The first product we're going to look at is Tableau. If you haven't heard of Tableau, you're probably very new to visualizations. Tableau has in excess of 57,000 customers worldwide. I would say they're the biggest specific visualization tool that's out there. So in terms of a lot of job opportunities, yeah, there's a lot of companies that are going to use Tableau. Tableau is also really simple to learn to use. There's a pretty good resource base online, both from the company and from other users, because there's just so many people using it. So I think that makes it pretty simple to use. To me, it's a pretty intuitive system to learn, especially if you've got analytics experience or analytics skills already. You're gonna find it pretty straightforward. The vast usage of Tableau carries over into their visualization quality. They have great visualization and the ability to do interactive reports, which I think are going to become more and more the standard. I think that eventually we're going to move away from so many standard static reports, maybe in PowerPoint that get circulated in companies, and more towards a dashboard interactive setup that makes it easy to get information on demand and it doesn't become obsolete the moment that it gets published. Now we're on to the fourth criteria, which is big data or small data. Tableau is really better suited for big data than small data, and part of that's because of the setup. It really works best when there's servers in the background that are structured and feeding into, or that Tableau is sitting on top of. They have a ton of integrations with things like Hadoop, Amazon Web Services, MySQL, SAP, tons of other connections that they have. This again gets back into big data, where there needs to be more structure. There's probably an internal IT department, or at least an on-call IT department that does a lot of work with a company that's managing all of these integrations. And in terms of cost, because of this, Tableau can sometimes be more expensive, not so much for the software itself, but for all of the other integration and the background structure that needs to be in place to be able to use it. Still, it's so widely used, almost 60,000 different companies using it, that it is a fantastic option to learn. And I think it's a tool that's really interesting to learn, gives great visualizations. The next product that we'll talk about is Qlikview. This is really Tableau's main competitor. Right now, they're at a little over 40,000 different customers using their installation. This is something that I actually learned by myself, and I was shocked at how quick it was to learn. There are a lot of things that are specific to how Qlikview works that do take a little bit of time to figure out, but there's, again, a lot of resources online to help you. And once you figure it out, it's really straightforward. So I would say in well under a week, I was pretty familiar with building dynamic reports, importing lots of different data sources. It was pretty straightforward to get set up with. You may also find that a lot of companies that have another software also use Qlikview because it's pretty cheap to install and it gives so much flexibility. Qlikview is one of the few tools that I think is fantastic for both big data visualization and small data visualization. If you want to go big, you can go massive. You can have all of those data warehouses. You can have all of the IT structure that Qlikview is drawing from. But if you want to go small, you can import Excel files as your data sources. And this is one of the ways that I've used it in the past, is taking a lot of Excel sources where I couldn't fit all of the information into one Excel and have it function with any amount of speed, but I could take them into Qlikview and take 10 different things that I wouldn't want to cram into one Excel sheet and work instantaneously within Qlikview, just working on my desktop. In terms of cost and ease of setup, this really goes back to how the company wants to set it up. Like I said, you can get started the day you get the software. They do offer some free options for download and use that limit how much you can share the information and the files you create, but are a fantastic way for you to be able to learn Qlikview for free. The third tool we're going to look at, and I recommend using, is Power BI. This is really widely available. Again, you can get your hands on a copy that has some limits, but that'll let you learn it for no cost. And if you're familiar with other Microsoft products, and let's be honest, if you don't know Excel, you're probably not getting into an analyst job. So you'll probably find Power BI very easy to use. It's very similar to the rest of their setup. They have great visualizations, a great database of content there to be able to use. Power BI doesn't have the variety of visualizations that Tableau and Qlikview offer, but for most people, it's going to be more than sufficient for what you need. If you're getting into more advanced things, you might need to look at a different system, but 90% of the time, Power BI is going to have you covered. Power BI is a tool that I recommend more for small to medium-sized amounts of data. It right now doesn't function really well with big data sets, though that's something that they're working on and I expect in the future will be solved. But right now, it's really better for smaller volumes of information. Because of that, the cost and ease of setup is also pretty low if you're using small amounts of data. And I would recommend using the desktop version. It just seems to function better. That may change in a month. If you're watching this a month or a year from now, I'm sure it will have changed. I hope it will have changed because they are constantly working on improving it. But right now, it's really more of a small to medium-sized company sort of program to look at. The fourth type of data visualization program is really several options, and that's Python, R, and SAS. So if you already know these languages, then you can create fantastic visualizations within the tools. If you don't know these languages, this is going to be the hardest of the options I'm talking about today to learn, because there is a lot of information to learn out there. On the plus side, there are fantastic resources online. You can find the answer to most questions. And if you can't find the answer, there's a wealth of different people using it that will probably help you solve the problem. In terms of the quality of visualizations, it's usually pretty good. You can make really complex visualizations, but where I would dock a few points on all of the programming visualizations is the more complex the visualization, the more complex the programming is going to have to be to pull it off. So it can be more time consuming than using one of the more data visualization geared programs. If you already know the skills for these, you could use them for small data, specifically Python and R. But in the vast majority of cases, this only makes sense for big data, because you're going to have data warehouses set up and a lot of data structure behind the scenes for this. You can do some small data, but it's really, these options are massive overkill for small data, because it's probably going to be, one, really expensive if you get SAS. I love SAS. I think it's a fantastic program, but it comes with a price tag that matches the flexibility and options that they have. And the same with Python and R. Not that they're expensive to install and to do the software, because we're talking about mostly open source options, but it can be really expensive to set up the background. And that also means a lot of time to set up the background. But if you know how to use these tools already, then learn the visualization aspect of them beyond just the analytics and more analysis side of using this coding. And fifth, how could I leave out Excel? This is so basic, and I think a lot of analysts really just kind of makes them shudder when they hear, I need you to know Excel, because we know that there are so many more powerful tools. All of these other options that I talk can do more than what Excel can do. But if you're working as an analyst and you're doing ad hoc analysis or working with small amounts of data, it's really hard to beat Excel. It's really quick to set up. They have a good variety of simple visualizations. You are going to be limited, but it really does offer a lot of options, especially for small companies and small amounts of data, that even if you know how to use all the other tools, it still may be quicker to do it in Excel for some of the smaller ad hoc simple reporting that you need to do. So those are my recommendations for the 5 to 8, depending on how you define my programming languages, tools to learn for data visualization. Which ones do you know? I personally haven't worked very much with Tableau, but I love Qlikview. I've worked with SAS, of course Excel, and dabbled in Power BI. So I'm really interested to learn more on each of these, but let me know, which one are you working on learning, or do you already know? Do you agree with what I picked? Do you think I missed something major that's another system people should be using? In the next few weeks, I'll also be talking about what programming languages you should learn and other data analytics tools you should know how to use. So be sure to come back or subscribe and turn on notifications to find out when those videos go up.